Dr. Jason Saunders here. Our next question is, why 40 hours? So if you don't know what I'm talking about, when people go online and they take a look, you know, natural therapies for this condition or that condition, they finally find hyperbaric oxygen, and then they start looking up protocols around hyperbaric oxygen for that particular condition, so many times it's listed as the protocol is 40 hours. Honestly, there's not a great reason for it. Now, I will say this, 40 hours is an enormous amount of oxygen. By 40 hours, especially if you're doing 4 to 6 hours a week, you know, for 4 to 6 weeks, and you're getting a tremendous amount of oxygen that way, you're going to see differences in most conditions that it's appropriate to treat with hyperbaric oxygen. So it is a great number. It is a very solid protocol, and it does deliver an extraordinarily high amount of oxygen over a length of time, which is really why and how hyperbaric oxygen works the best. Now, that being said, it really depends on the severity of the condition and how long the person's been suffering and what condition we're even talking about. So there are certain cases where, you know, 5 or 10 sessions is really great and people get a ton of benefit from that, and that's all they need. There's also times where people need 80 or 100 hours or even more. And so there's no particular reason that 40 is the magic number, other than in a lot of research, the protocols for the research have been based around either 20-hour protocols or 40-hour protocols. Now, you know, we have to use clinical judgment when we're working with people, and we have to decide what's the right thing for them. And so, like I said, you know, there are certain conditions where 5 or 10 sessions is totally enough. It's more than enough. They heal really well, and that's the end of the story. There's also times where if the condition is degenerative over time, there might be an initial loading dose. And so that might be 20 hours or that might be 40 hours. But because the condition itself is degenerative, which means it's literally breaking down over time, there might be an initial phase and then there might be a maintenance phase. And so somebody might do 20 or 40 hours for an initial phase in a short period, like I was describing, 4 to 6 hours a week for 4 to 6 weeks. And then there might go into some sort of maintenance mode where they're doing once a week or twice a week or once a month. It really just depends. So, you know, the basis for a lot of this is clinical judgment, severity of condition, and the length of time the person's been suffering with the issue, and whether or not it's a trauma, in which case, once you heal, you should be done, versus a degenerative disease where once you're finished with your initial phase, there's probably some type of maintenance to do afterwards.